Junction Television Network. Clodhopper, Papillon, Darcy Wilson, Ron and Marty, Whittler Dan, Sarah Edens, and Deputy Les. Come and join us for a half hour of fun and games at Joy Junction. Now here's Sheriff Don.
Hello and welcome to Joy Junction.
Hi,
today.
Hi,
Professor.
Yeah, I had to stop and get a few things. I'm over at my shop working on a great, great invention.
You are?
Yeah. Everything here, hold this for a minute. I'm going to explain it to you. Everything nowadays is in color. Look here. Color coat hangers.
Yeah.
Look here. Colored noodles, you know. All kind of colored noodles. And look here. Even colored cereal. Everything's in color, you know. They even like these old movies now. Look at the colored cereal.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. Everything's in color.
They're taking these old movies, and they're even making them in color now, too. You know. And look at here. Even got
toothpaste in color, too?
Yeah. Let me show you.
Everything's in color.
Hold out your hand here a minute.
My hand?
Yeah.
But, Professor Clark.
Look at that color. See that color?
Yeah, I see that.
Everything's in color. And, you know, I'm making a color remover.
A color
remover, yeah. I've got to go now. I'll see you, okay?
You're going to make a car, but wait a minute,
yeah.
Professor. What about my hand? I've got that. Oh, brother. Anyhow, let's go ahead and meet our first two contestants. So come on right up here, contestants. And I'll tell you, if you wouldn't mind, excuse me just for a minute. Maybe, Deputy Les, do you have some paper towels we can wipe this up with? And while we're doing that, maybe, Dave, you can show them the nice awards they're going to receive for being on Joy Junction.
Each contestant will receive a beautiful full-color T-shirt to remember their exciting visit to Joy Junction. Today's winners will receive a beautiful Joy Junction watch with the letters PGF to remind them that it is always time to put God first. Back to you, Sheriff Don.
Thank you, Deputy Les. There, I feel a little bit better. Professor and his inventions. All right, let's meet our first two contestants. You pick a team. Who do you think's going to win? Will it be the blue side or the red side? We'll know in just a little while. And what is your name?
Crystal.
And your last name? How old are you, Crystal?
9.
And what grade are you in?
3rd.
Crystal, do you have any pets at home?
6.
You have 6 pets? My goodness, what are they?
Well, I've got 6 cats and then 3 dogs.
Really. 6 cats and 3 dogs. Boy, that's a house full, isn't it? You like pets?
Yes.
If you could have any other kind of pet in the whole world, what would you like to have?
Some kind of bird.
I don't know. Birds. Okay. Very good. Pets are fun to have. All right, and let's meet your opponent over here. What is your name?
Sarah Hamlin.
And how old are you, Sarah?
7.
And what grade are you in?
2nd.
Do you have any brothers and sisters at home?
Yeah.
How many?
1.
1? Boy or girl?
Girl.
Sister, huh? Is she older or younger than you?
Older.
Oh, so she takes good care of you, right?
No.
Does she do all the work around the house for you?
Yeah.
Does she do her homework for you?
Sometimes.
Oh, I hear that. All right. We'll have to be talking to your sister. All right, we're ready for our first contest, and Deputy's got it going over there right now. So let's move right over here, and let's get by your, by your darts. And what we want you to do is, when I say go, is for you to throw darts at that board and see if you can hit the balloons that are under your color. You're going to be trying for the red ones, and you'll be trying for the background that's blue. So you can get most of them broken, and it'll be worth 20 points for your team. Are you ready? On your mark, get set, go. Start throwing. Oh, good. There's one for the reds. It's exposed. Good. Oh, there goes one more. We'll count that. It's gone. So there's 2 red exposed. Quickly throw it. Good. There's another red one. Oh, that one bounced right off, didn't it? Oh, there's a blue and a red. All right. And the red side is won. Let's hear it for the red team. All right. They leap out in front with 20 points because there's still 3 blue ones up there.
Whoa.
All right.
Hey. Sheriff Don, that's a good game. You know,
that is a fun one, isn't it?
I was listening to Professor before, you know, about the colored thing, mm-hmm. and a lot of it is maybe we. And look, can I show you something?
Sure. Woo!
See, you've been having fun. But, you know, in color, everything we look at, magazines and everything, right? Yeah, let me remove this here. This is a poster we did one time
that's our
here
Junction
at Junction. At Junction, mm-hmm. right? Remember that mm-hmm. poster?
Sure.
Now, this was a printer's proof, we call it, right? Mm-hmm. Now, to show you how color works in printing, these are done in separations. Maybe we'll give it a little education on printing.
Okay.
Now, this is your black plate.
Oh, did you see that?
Now, what the camera does is take and has all these little tiny dots. Here, I have some of these little dots here. I'll show you here.
Uh-huh.
Here, you hold that a minute.
Okay, I'll hold it.
Now, the little dots are all together, mixed on here. In other words, they're at a different angle. See,
uh-huh.
for the black plate, they may be at a 45-degree angle.
Uh-huh.
But for the, right, we still got color there. Now, for the blue plate, they may be at a 30-degree angle.
Uh-huh.
You see? But we still have the image there.
Uh-huh.
Now, look what happens on the red plate,
now.
Right? We still have some image here,
mm-hmm.
right?
Now, and there's the yellow.
This is the yellow
is
plate.
Is it? That's something? Uh-huh.
Now, this is maybe a 20-degree angle, right? And, of course, the red plate, right?
Uh-huh.
Now,
and there's the red.
Now, see here. Let me show you a close-up on how this works.
All of these made up all those different colors. They mixed in and made
That's
all the
right.
four colors.
So let's say, for example, these are the dots on the board, right?
Uh-huh.
And if you want to take and run...
You want me to hold this up there for you?
Well, maybe you could. Sure.
Okay.
Okay. Let's say now we got the red, yellow, and blue. Supposing we took the blue,
uh-huh.
and then we made another dot. This is just the same way that happens over here, see? Now, you notice in here, we get the purple.
Oh, yeah.
And here we get the green.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
See? Now, supposing we were to take and run these for all the colors, right? Okay, we started with blue, right? Now, look at how it affects all the colors here. See?
It turns the yellow green.
You got the green there.
The red purple.
Let's try the yellow.
Okay.
The yellow plate. We run that across there, see?
Huh. And we get some more different colors
you
all
get
blended
the different
together,
colors,
huh?
Right? And what color? We need a little bit of red here. See, color is kind of funny, Sheriff Don. See? Well, being this is only water, you really can't see it too good.
But it's made of different colors. In other words, you blend two colors together and you get another color.
That's right, just like a watermelon. What color is the watermelon before you open it up?
Well, you got me. I guess it's red on the inside.
No. Color, now remember, color does not exist without light.
Oh.
And you know, Jesus said in Ephesians, I got my little note here. I didn't memorize. In Ephesians 5:8, he says, "For you were sometimes darkness, but now you are light in the Lord Jesus. So walk as children of the light."
Of the light.
Make sure
right.
the light
and
is
light
up.
Makes all the beautiful colors come out in us. That's really neat.
Sheriff Don.
Yeah.
You know,
Dan?
I was sitting here thinking about how much the Bible talks about colors, you know, especially in the Old Testament. But I was reading here in John chapter 19, verse 2. It says, "When they crucified Jesus, that the soldiers put a crown of thorns on his head, and they put a purple robe on him."
Right.
And I remember the disciples one time, they were up on the top of a mountain with him, and all of a sudden it said that his clothes kind of changed colors, and there he stood in a white robe in front of them. And it was kind of a... Well, it kind of told something else that was going to happen to him later on after he was crucified and rose from the dead, that he was going to ascend into heaven. And when he did, he went in a white robe. There was purple and white in there. And Dorsey was just telling me, she's got a song about soon and very soon, Jesus is going to come back. Mm-hmm. He said he's going to come back in a white robe again.
Mm-hmm.
Dorsey, why don't you sing that for us?
Going to see.
Sheriff Don, I think I'm going to go down there and see what the professor's up to, see, keep him out of trouble if I can.
Okay, Whittler Dan, while you go and check that out, we're going to let you check something out, and we'll be right back in just a few seconds.
I have a challenge for you today. Say about three nice things to your brother or sister.
Hey kids, I have a challenge for you. Pray for your teachers today.
All right, it's time now for our next game. And
Sheriff Don, I did it.
You,
I
Professor,
did it.
Yeah. What'd you do?
I invented it. Yeah,
the,
I got it.
The color remover
yeah,
we're talking
I sure
about?
Yeah, I did. Right there. Right there. Professor's color remover.
Professor's color remover.
Right.
That's what it says. Whittler Dan just went to see how you were coming.
Well, I came the back alleyway this time because I didn't want anybody to see what I had for my invention.
But Professor, what can that do?
It removes the color. Let me show you.
That, I sure would. I'd like to see how that works. Why, Professor, it's working. It's working. Look at this. I just went black and white.
Black
I don't
white.
Believe it. Yeah. My goodness, it really works.
Sure does.
That's amazing.
Color.
That is.
Yeah.
So anything you don't like the color on, you can just spray it.
And
Professor,
it.
That's one of the neatest inventions you've ever
you
made.
That.
That's amazing.
Okay,
thank you a lot.
Okay.
Wait. How do we get back now into all our pretty colors? We want to get back to the color.
Get back?
Yeah.
I didn't think of that.
Professor Clark, you better be kidding now.
I am.
Good.
I made another invention here.
Oh, good.
See?
That says color restorer.
Color restorer.
Oh.
So that puts it back.
I got to see. I hope that works.
Okay.
Please, that works. All right. Hey, it worked. It worked, Professor.
How about that, huh?
Hey, that's
like
tremendous.
That?
Boy, I'll tell you what. I feel a lot better now, all in color.
So I can take it, leave it.
Thanks, Professor. We're going to go meet our next two contestants. So come on right up here, contestants. Let's get ready for our next contest. The red team, is ahead now by 20 points. But Blue, maybe you can catch up this time because this game is going to be worth 20 points. And what is your name?
Julie Pearson.
And how old are you?
10. Mm-hmm.
And what grade are you in, Julie?
5th.
What do you like to do in your spare time?
Go out and play.
Go out and play? Do you play any kind of musical instrument?
Uh-huh.
What instrument is it?
Alto clarinet.
Well, nice. How long have you been taking lessons on that?
Just this year.
Takes a lot of practice, doesn't it? But you stay with it, you'll do a good job before long, I'm sure. And what is your name?
Ginger Blanks.
And what grade are you in?
5th.
And how old are you?
10.
What do you like to do in your spare time?
Play
too. What's your favorite food? If I said I'll make anything to eat you want, what would you ask for?
Pizza.
I'll tell you, I get pizza more than anything else. What's your favorite dessert?
Cake.
Cake? Do you have any idea what you want to be when you get out of school, grown up, and get all the education out of the way?
A teacher.
Do you? Good. In public schools or regular school teacher?
Public.
Good. Very good. All right, I think that's a neat thing to want to be. Nice to meet both of you. And Deputy Les, let's get ready to go for our first contest. Girls, Deputy Les has found a lot of colors that are mentioned in the Bible, and he's marked them there in your Bible, so it will be real easy. All you have to do is open your Bible, turn to that verse, and see what color there is mentioned, and then put that color up on the board, okay? You just have about a minute to do it, so let's see how quickly who can find the most colors on your mark. Get set, go! Find the color that's mentioned in that verse, and then go to the next one. All right. Looks like they're starting a rainbow, doesn't it? Who's going to get the most colors? Go quickly, because the one that gets the most, the soonest, is going to get 20 points for their side. All right, there's a beautiful color of purple. All right, it's 3-2 so far. Red side is ahead, but here comes blue catching up. It is 4-3 now. Red side is still ahead. Who's going to find them? All right, you have them all. Red side has them all first. Let's hear it for the red team. They win 20 more points. All right, girls, you can be seated. And that puts the red side way out in front. But either team can still win. Okay, give the red side a nice hand. Will you do that again? They are way in the lead. Carson
McDonald, it's so good to see you. Hello
there. What have you there?
Well, I have my little friend, McCall Parrott from South America.
Oh, my.
This is Buddy, you know.
Buddy?
Oh, yes,
well,
he's delightful.
Hello, Buddy.
You know,
okay,
hello, Buddy. Would you like something to eat there? Oh, he likes peanuts.
Oh,
they're
my
very, very
goodness.
Very delightful little
that
peanuts.
That even looks like a green-colored peanut.
It's a green-colored peanut there. You see, he'll, see, he could take that little tongue of his, and he could flip that over and turn it around and get it out without dropping it, you see?
Oh, that's
delightful.
Neat.
They like fruit sometimes, but mostly they're very messy. Would you like something else, Buddy? Oh, you want the other peanut
there?
Yeah,
goes for another peanut.
Oh, yes, very much there.
Mike, what kind
of beautiful color there?
Is that?
He's a macaw parrot,
yeah?
You see. They're one of the most colorful and beautiful of all the birds. He's not the largest, however. There's a much larger one. But he is very beautiful, and what I like about him is all the beautiful colors, you see.
Uh-huh.
You know, some parrots have, Buddy doesn't have a whole lot of red on him, but you'll notice very carefully, look at the design of the feathers around his eyes.
Oh, beautiful.
Isn't it delightful?
And green and
it
blue and yellowish
looks
gold and black and white.
It reminds me about the scripture in Genesis chapter 9, verse 12, I believe. It says that God put his bow in his rainbow in the clouds,
mm-hmm,
after the flood there.
That's
so
right.
That Noah would have a promise that God would never flood the earth again and
that's
destroy
right
it that way.
That's right.
And I think that God is the master artist. You know, Papillon's pretty good over there.
Yeah.
But, you know, God can mix colors. And what I like is looking on top of his head. God mixes those colors, and he'll always have the same colors most of his life there, see?
Huh.
And see, look how gentle he is.
Oh, isn't that
something? Oh, yes.
But I'll bet that jaw is quite powerful,
isn't
it?
Oh, it's very, very powerful. He could break my skin and my bone if he wanted to.
Could he really?
He hasn't tried it there very much.
Oh, he's very, very keen.
He likes colors. He likes to change. He likes to go to the highest place, you know.
Oh, is that right?
If I hold this other hand up over here, he'll climb up on top of that, won't you?
Quite,
look at there, see?
Quite a pet,
see?
Isn't he?
He likes to be very high
and
in the tree.
His name is Buddy.
Oh,
Jungle Bob.
I brought him over to see Whitla Dan. Have you seen him around here anywhere?
I'm sorry. He went over to find Professor Clodhopper, and Professor was coming in the back alleyway.
Well, I'll bet Whitla Dan's following him in that direction, so I'll take Buddy over and show him.
Okay, I'm
Buddy,
sure he would
go.
Like
say
to.
Say ta-ta for
thank
now.
Thank you, Jungle
there.
Bob. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye-bye.
Wow, that sure was a pretty bird, wasn't it, Ron? It certainly was, Marty. Had a lot of real nice colors. You know, I learned a verse in the Bible that has color in it, too. Oh? Really, which one is that, Marty? Psalms 23:2. And what does that say? It says, he maketh me to lie down in the green pastures, and he leadeth me beside the still waters. That's a beautiful verse, Marty. I've heard that quoted many times. Did you learn that in Sunday school? No, the Mailbox Club. Oh, you're a part of the Mailbox Club, huh? Yeah, it's a lot of fun. You see, Ron, what you do is... Oh, wait a minute, Marty. I happen to have it right here because Sheriff Don asked me to mention this, but you go right ahead and talk about it, okay? Yeah, that's it, all right. Well, what you do is you write in and you send us your name, your address, and your age, and send it to Joy Junction, P.O. Box 6922, Clearwater, Florida, 34618. And then we'll send your mailbox lesson to you, and you read the lesson in there and open it up, Ron. Oh, okay. And you answer the questions, and then after that you mail it back, and we grade it. And after you've finished a series of lessons, Sheriff Don will send you a certificate. Well, that sounds like a lot of fun and a real fun way to learn about the Bible, Marty. And don't forget about the notepad, Ron. Wait a minute, Marty. You're sitting on it. Ouch, that hurt. Oh, here it is right here. Anyway, if you'll write in and ask for this free Joy Junction notepad, we'll send that to you also. It says, remember to put God first. And you can write down your homework assignments and just all kinds of things that you want to remember. And that's a really neat way to remember things, isn't it, Marty? Yeah, and you'll remember to put God first because that's the most important thing. That's right, isn't it, Sheriff?
Oh, that sure is. That's kind of our theme around here. Put God first. Isn't it interesting, all the colors that are mentioned in the Bible? My goodness, we've heard about red and green and blue and yellow and white and all these different colors God has mentioned in the Bible. We are very, very special to the Lord.
Sheriff Don.
Yeah, Whitler.
Couldn't find the professor anywhere.
Oh, he was here. He came the alleyway, and He showed us an invention that you wouldn't believe. Turned us all black and white. But, you know, Jungle Bob was looking for you. Did you see Jungle Bob?
No.
Oh, he's here with a big, beautiful bird, and he wanted to show it to you.
You know, I got a phone call from him. He said he had a macaw he was going to bring over.
That's right, he did.
I'm sorry I missed him.
Well, maybe you can find him anyway. He left. Yeah, he went back that way towards your house.
I'll see if I can catch him.
All right,
take it easy now.
Good to see you. All right, it's
done.
Yes, Sarah?
I found the color red.
The color red? Where'd you find that?
Right here in Genesis 25:30. It says, "And Esau said to Jacob, please let me have a swallow of that red stuff there, for I am famished."
And it was red, it's called pottage or something, some kind of soup or cereal or something like, and it's red.
I don't think I can stand red pottage.
Would you give up a birthright for a bowl of red pottage?
No,
I don't think I would either. But that's something he did. That's an interesting story about Esau. My goodness, all the neat colors we can find in the Bible. Right now we're going to see how well the girls do in the Bible Pumper, because it is our final contest. And Ginger is representing the red side and Julie for the blue side. We're going to see which team will win. The score is 40-0 right now. Red side, you are ahead, but either team can win, because you will get 10 points for each of these correct answers. 10 points for every time you answer the question right. So keep your button right out there, ready to push it down. If you know the answer, your light will light up, the buzzer will ring, and we'll know your first answer to the question. What did God put in the sky to remind us that he would never again destroy the world with a flood? Red side.
A rainbow.
A rainbow. You are right, and there's 10 more points for the red team. Esau sold his birthright for a bowl of what color pottage? Blue side?
Red.
Red. Yes, you were listening well. Sarah just found that verse of scripture for us, didn't she? All right, I want you to fill in this blank. I'm going to quote a verse, and you fill in the blank. Psalm 51:7 says, "Wash me, and I shall be blank than snow." Wash me, blue side? Whiter. Yes, absolutely. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. At the crucifixion of Christ, what color robe did they put on him? Red side?
Red.
No, I'm sorry. Blue side, do you know?
Purple.
It is purple. That's right. So there's 10 more points for the blue side. And our score is 50-30. Red side, you are still in the lead. There is a color mentioned in the 23rd Psalm. Can you name it? If you can say the 23rd Psalm to yourself, you'll come up with a color that's mentioned in the 23rd. Okay, red side?
Green.
You got it. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. Very good. Who gave Joseph a beautiful coat of many colors? Who gave Joseph a beautiful coat of many colors? Quickly. Okay, blue side?
Father?
His father, yes. And there's 10 more points for the blue side. And that is the last question we have time for. So the winner is red side, 60-40. Let's hear it for the red team. All right, so the red team has won, Pastor
Wilson. I like that. That's a good game there.
Isn't it neat how well they know their Bible? I mean, they don't have any helps. They're not coached. They just have to listen and know their Bible.
Looks to me like you were discussing the colors that are in the Bible.
We were. We were talking about all the different colors that are in the Bible. Do you know any verses that have any colors in, by the way?
I've got a couple favorites. Let me show you.
Okay.
The scripture right here. Oh, yes, in Isaiah chapter 1 and verse 18. Listen closely now. God says, "Let's talk this over, says the Lord. No matter how deep the stain of your sin, I can take it out and make you clean as freshly fallen snow. Even if you're stained red as crimson, I can make it white as wool."
Oh.
You know what my two favorite colors are? The crimson, the red of crimson, which reminds me of everybody covered with sin as they come into the world, the darkness of doing things wrong and against God.
Mm-hmm.
It's a real true fact that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God.
The Bible tells us, right? Every one of us. Yeah.
But I've got another good color, Sheriff Don, and that's white. Because God says he can clean us white as freshly fallen snow, make us look as white as wool. And it's such a clean feeling. I'm telling you, there's a big difference there. But those two colors remind us all the time about ourselves and what God can do for us if we have Jesus in the right place.
That is good, Pastor Wilson. Boy, that is good. Because that is right. That's exactly what happens. We have all sinned. The Bible says that Jesus died for our sin. He paid the price or the penalty for our sin, didn't he?
That's right.
But until we call on him and accept him as their Savior, we are still covered with that darkness and with that sin. And when we say he'll wash us as white as snow, that's referring to the sin that's within us. That rejection of God. We've just turned away from God. We're not following God's way. Remember, sin is just disobeying God. That's all it is. And every one of us have disobeyed God. But the only way to be washed clean on the inside as white as snow is to ask Jesus to forgive us. He died to forgive us of our sins. But we've got to turn to him and give our heart to him. If you've never done that, why don't you do that right now? Give your life to Jesus. And then write to us and join the Mailbox Club, because it'll teach you a lot more about what God's Word says about the Bible and how you can be born again and how you can be freed from the sins that you have and that all of us had have. Jesus loves you, and he really wants to forgive you. Just give your life to him. Attend church, read your Bible, pray every day, and always remember PGF reminds us to what?
Put God first!
Put God first, kids, and we'll see you next week. Oh.